Welcome back, everyone, and let's get started with the level 7 tower. Yeah, I was talking about that. In fact, you know what, before we do, let me just show you the boobies, which, as I said before, are some of the more powerful creatures in this level. So I just wanted to show you real quick what kind of damage we can expect from them. Actually, I kind of want to know myself as well, because I haven't checked yet with my new armor, my new levels, and that sort of thing. I'm pretty sure they are dangerous still. So we have to be a little bit careful, but you do have to experiment a little bit, otherwise we don't know what we can or cannot take. Now the different spawns of boobies are all pretty similar in strength, so the amount of damage they do to you, but they do vary a little bit in details like how they move and how many hit points they have and that sort of thing. So I'm hoping I might be able to get this one. Yeah, from the side, okay. So the first spawn is relatively easy. They're slow, they don't come straight for you, so yeah, that's the more acceptable spawn. Let me see if I can make another one spawn. Oh yeah, there it is. Now the second spawn obviously is more aggressive. It heads straight for you, but it's still pretty slow, thankfully. I think all the boobies are relatively slow, so that makes it a little bit easier. But you won't be able to stab these guys from the side or anything. And as you can see, they do 30,000 damage in a single hit, so nothing to sneeze at. So this was the second spawn. Still a lot of food, not the most valuable stuff, but we will see with the next spawn, they start becoming a lot more interesting. They also have a lot more hit points, clearly. But they're still pretty slow, and their movement's still pretty predictable, which means we can actually take out these guys, hopefully without taking any damage. Non-aggressive monster types are always a lot easier, of course. And as I said, they give us some wing boots. Wing boots, if you want to buy them, cost 10,000 gold, which clearly is not cheap. And they are extremely useful in a lot of different situations, so it's definitely worth having a look at picking them up. Now these guys are the aggressive type, so there's no way I'm going to avoid getting hit, unless of course I'm fast enough. Yeah. Oh, that's right, the final spawn is very low defense, so if you're quick enough, you can just kill them without getting hurt yourself. So that's some boobies out of the way, some more fighter experience. We are... Oh, that's nice, we're actually over 200,000 now. We might be able to level up our fighter again. But for the time being, what we really want is, I think, to get into this tower. Or is there anything else I really wanted to show? Not really, no. See these paths down here? This is where you want to go, because that's what leads back to the exits, both to the higher levels and to the lower ones. But I think we can actually avoid opening all these doors, which is going to be good, because as you can see, that would waste quite a lot of our keys. Okay, well, before we go into that, first things first, let's get into the tower. Now, as you can see, this tower is a little bit empty again, similar to the one we saw in, what was it, level 3, I believe. And unfortunately, this tower is almost completely empty all the way through, which means no gold, no experience, no items, basically empty rooms. And if you remember from what I was saying before, since there's only one tower, that means it fills all the rooms, all the tower rooms in the level, so there's quite a lot of them. I haven't counted them, but at least in excess of 40 or 50 rooms that are completely empty. In addition, a lot of these rooms have openings which lead to slightly different areas, which means that it's very easy to lose your way or to end up back at the starting point, even though you feel like you've made some headway. You know what, I'm debating whether I should show you the proper path which you're kind of supposed to take. Yeah, you know what, let me put blue MSX on a little bit of acceleration here and show you in a very quick detail the route you would normally have to take if you don't want to sort of trick the game. Which is, first you'd have to go all the way up here, and then go all the way to the right. And then go down this way to 3, 4, and then go left here, 1, 2, and then down. Which means we're now over here, down again. It's a good thing I have my map, because there's no way I would be able to do this without looking at the map. Then to the right, from the right we go down again, which brings us here, then we go left twice. Took me quite some time to figure this one out, as you can see. Left twice, oops, I think I went left too early. Wait a minute, where are we? Yep, I did go left too early, so I have to go back up. And then to the right again. Which means I'm here, another one to the right, and then down. This was correct so far. And then left and down, is that right? No. See, even though I have a map, I'm already pretty lost. I'm not quite sure where I am right now. Unless this is a four-way. No, this is a three-way. If I go down here and then to the left. Do I now only have a way up? Is that right? No, it's a three-way again. Damn it. Oh wait, maybe I'm here. So I have to go left twice, is that right? 1, 2. Yeah, I think I got it. Okay, yep, I know where I am now. Okay, so down and then back to the right. And then right again. No, down first. So down here, now we have a three-way, which we will take left, or right, sorry. And then down again, and then right again. And then down again. At which point we go to the left. Left. Up, left, down. Up, left, down. Okay, down again, and then all the way to the right, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, now we go right. 1, 2, 3. And this is where we end up in the teleport, I think. Yep, okay, we're almost there. So for our trouble, we get a halberd and a +4 small shield. And then we go right 1, 2, 3 more times. And now we go down. Okay, and this is actually where we need to go. As you can see, it's... let me just reset the speed to normal. Now we're actually almost there. We can pick up some pretty decent spare equipment here. Kill a couple of dragons, which are the only normal monsters in this entire tower. also get some items that we can sell later, because of course we already have much better weapons than this. Although we do pick up a +4 small shield, which is going to be worth it. A large shield even. A small one as well, but oh well. 9 spare keys, which is also very nice, of course. And then finally, some random, pretty powerful items. A mushroom is always nice, of course. Bunch of pendants, fire crystal, some boots, and a mushroom. But as you can see, we burned through 50,000 food just getting here, and that's even though I had a map which gave me a pretty clear indication of where I wanted to go. Oh, by the way, if we go one more left here, we get to the end boss of this level, but I don't want to go there quite yet because that will save my game. And I actually want to do this again, but slightly differently, to show you the slightly easier way to get into the tower. But I see we are close to running out of time, so I will do that in the next video. I hope this wasn't too boring for you guys. I will see you in the next part.